In today's video, I'm going to be demonstrating to you guys how to properly inoculate your all-in-one grow kit in a bag for dung-loving and wood-loving mushrooms. Now, before we get started, prior to starting to this video, I took some 70% isopropyl alcohol and took a nice wipe down of this entire area to make sure it's absolutely clean. You're going to hear us talk about this over and over again, but sterility is absolutely critical in mycology in preventing contamination from happening in the future. So just make sure that you take your time to clean the area, turn the AC off if there's AC blowing in the area, and try to reduce the amount of particulates flying in the air. So after you've wiped down your table, after you've wiped down your bags, and your bags are now prepped on your clean area, obviously make sure you're wearing your PPE. That includes your gloves and your mask. This is good practice for the future as your mycology skills start developing and you start using more advanced methods. For the sake of this video, I'm not going to be using the mask so you guys can hear me clear, but you're going to want to make sure you wear all of those things. Next, make sure you have your syringes prepped. Now, whether you're using a liquid culture syringe or a spore syringe will determine the timelines for your colonization. Spores have to first germinate, which means that they have to be in an ideal environment for the spores to create the mycelium before it starts developing and colonizing the bag. Whereas liquid culture is already in the mycelium form. As soon as you start injecting it into the bag, it's immediately going to start searching for that grain and that nutrition and start multiplying that mycelium exponentially quicker. So either way, make sure that everything is super clean. There's no such thing as too clean. And make sure you use the provided alcohol pads that come inside your grow kits and inside of your liquid culture syringes from mushroomsupplies.com. So let's go ahead and get started. First thing you're gonna wanna do, even though I already cleaned these bags with isopropyl alcohol, I'm going to make sure that I give it another good wipe down right before I inject it. And the first thing I wanna do is just make sure everything is ready and set up for use. So that includes attaching the needle to the syringe. I'm using the spore syringe right now to inject into our dung-loving bag. So make sure you just take your time. There's no rush in this. Make sure you're gently applying the top of the needle to the spore syringe, like that. Now that this is ready, what we are gonna wanna do is take this alcohol prep pad and give another good wipe down to this injection port area located on the front of the bag. And you can set this to the side. After a couple quick seconds, you'll see that kind of evaporate and you're ready to inject. First thing you're gonna wanna do is just make sure that you keep both hands on the bag and be very, very careful when you're removing this cap of the needle so as not to puncture yourself. And what you're gonna wanna do is gently glide this needle into the bag. Now, in mycology, you may hear people talk about, you know, is it better to inject everything all at once into one area, or is it better to spread out the liquid culture or the spores into multiple areas? And what we've found is that it's actually better to spread the spores and liquid culture into multiple areas to give the spores the highest chance of germinating quicker. Liquid culture, same thing. Spread it out into different areas so that that mycelium can start attaching itself to the grain and start multiplying quicker. So as I inject or slowly start pushing these spores in, what I'm gonna wanna do is kinda just give it a small circular motion to push that liquid into a few different areas in the bag. In this case, this spore syringe was 10 cc's of spores, and there we have it. Now that it's out, simply all you have to do is pull it out, return the cap to the needle. Again, be safe here, don't poke yourself, and then use the alcohol wipe again to give it a nice little wipe just to make sure it's absolutely clean. This bag is ready to go. Now, for the dung-loving bags, I'm going to use the liquid culture, but the process is going to be exactly the same. So you're going to want to make sure that you prepare your liquid culture syringe, like so. In this case, this is lion's mane. Your needle, which comes provided, and your alcohol wipe. And the same process like we did before, you're going to want to make sure you gently open this needle, slowly remove the cap of the syringe, and apply the needle to the top of the syringe here. Now that the syringe is ready, I'm going to give that injection port one more quick wipe down to make sure it's absolutely clean, and then we'll go ahead and inject it the same exact way. In this example, we're going to be using 20 cc's or 20 mls, milliliters, of liquid culture, which already, as you can see, has the mycelium growing in it. So this will actually develop and help colonize the bag much quicker. So here we go. Gently hold, release the cap. Aim for the injection port. Insert the needle. And in the same type of circular motion, slowly inject some of the liquid culture in one area, some liquid culture in another area here, and slowly but surely take your time again, moving this around and injecting the entire syringe. Again, slowly just remove it, return the cap to the needle, and make sure you put this in a safe place. Use the provided alcohol pad and wipe down the injection port, and now your bags are ready to go.